Do you remember it? That tale about flowers? I thought it was a good story. I thought it's sure to have a happy ending. Wrong. It's a tale about pain. Let me tell you again. These lands were dead, destroyed, and devastated. All you could hear was the whisper of the ashes. Then a stranger came. He held a spark in his hand. The stranger opened his hand, and the spark was set free. Light returned. Yet pain was the price for this light. Screaming filled the air. Time passed. The screaming grew silent. Pain became a familiar friend. Some disappeared from the lands. No one knew whether they had crept away or been taken by pain. Yet many also remained. Castles which once rose into the skies fell into ruins. Time wiped clean any trace. Centuries passed. The people started calling the stranger the Keeper of the Spark. He kept watch over the land, soaking up the pain of its people. People had hope. They were growing flowers. The light of the spark. Terrible its price. drove the keeper out of fear. Others served the keeper out of greed, expecting to be rewarded for their service. They went into the lands and they gathered the pain. And thus the pain multiplied. And their own hearts blackened.
Thank you. Thank you. No one knew where the people kept disappearing to. Pure-hearted grew their flowers, for the secret of the flowers lives on. Who lived in the light of their flowers were free from pain and hidden from the keeper's ever vigilant gaze. The knight could never grow his own flower. He stole someone else's. But the stolen flower would never accept him. It's wrong. The Knights will be forever damned for this. For all eternity.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
For as long as the spark shines over these lands, pain is locked inside every soul. Many have given up, accepting that the pain inside them will never subside. Fought to find a way out, to escape these lands. To a place where the Keeper has no dominion over them. Even those whose souls turned black, who gave in to their desires. Even they believe. Keeper won't ever let them go. Harvest and nurture and steal. And even more so, the pain they suffer themselves.
Thank you.
No one can leave while the Keeper still needs them. And the Keeper needs every ounce of pain. There is but one way out, to let the pain dissolve. Surrender to it. But the pure-hearted still grow their flowers, for the secret of the flowers lives on. Their flower are free from pain and hidden from the Keeper's ever-vigilant gaze. The flower fills their hearts with love, and the love stands in the way of the pain. And the Keeper no longer has use for it. But those who serve the Keeper can never have their own soul flower. There is no escape for them, for black are their souls. Even if you steal a flower, it'll never be yours. Such things should never happen.
flowers must stay with those who gave them life.
Thank you. never was a knight, you know. One way or another, we all serve the Keeper. And we all have our desires. Most importantly, his heart was not all black. He had grown his own soul flower. He did not manage to save it, though. And that was his undoing. And she, well, she never forgave him. But yes, he did steal that second flower. There is something you do not know, though. You were too young then, and no one told you. Everyone was so busy, so preoccupied with their own pain. He stole the flower from death. Stole you away. And accepted you with all his heart. She couldn't, though. She blamed him. She blamed you. Some have to face more pain than they can handle. And the pain broke her. She wanted them to leave together, to follow their flower. And that night, they did leave. She took him with her. She took my son. Thank you. the pain stays with us forever. It can subside. It may grow dull, but it'll never leave us. And we live with it, doing our best not to let it dissolve us. We fight it every day. But there are different kinds of pain. There's sacrificing yourself. The father, consumed by work, trying to give his child a better future. The mother, dedicating herself to her family until there is nothing left of her. Your pain is the price you pay to make someone else feel better. To make someone else smile, if only for a moment. But trading someone else's happiness for your pain is not the only way. Life doesn't want your pain. It doesn't need your suffering. It simply is what it is. You don't have to fight it. All we can do is remember those who are gone and do our best for those who remain. All of us carry our pain within us. Another way, even if you're in pain, another way is to take someone else's pain and make it your own.
Do you remember it? That tale about pain? I was wrong. It's a tale about love. I will tell you. Tell you once again.